Our customers know that we love two things, drinks and technology. That's why we built the world's first purpose-built spirits e-commerce website in the first place. Because we love drinks and technology. And cats. Three things.
So we've always dreamed about having our own distillery, as I'm sure most whisky geeks have. But we have kept an eye on other industries too.
It all started with a natural interest in additive processes to reduce some waste and costs. Some see them as a novelty still, a technology for tomorrow, but they actually first emerged back in the 1980s.
Once we got bored of printing funny 3D models, we'd start on the product prototypes, and then we'd say things like, protective phone cases for staff? Can we do that?
Why don't we just print those coat hooks that we need? And then what about that part we need for the warehouse door?
Soon we had the bug. We were chasing the smartest filaments, the latest rapid liquid printing techniques. And there's a whole spectrum of 3D printing, but then there's also 4D printing. That's when things got really interesting.
The further we went, the more we'd say, okay, where's the limit? How are others overcoming these issues? And it all snowballed from there.
We're delighted this Easter to finally announce our plans to build our own state-of-the-art whisky distillery.
So we'll be creating truly innovative new whiskies using cutting-edge additive processes at every single step along the way.
For example, we're actually 3D printing the distillery building itself from reclaimed building materials and cement, which may sound bonkers, but it really isn't.
We suddenly had this incredible sandbox on our hands. Anything was possible.
So naturally, what the still should be like was on all of our minds, and after months of deliberation, they're due to be printed.
More accurately, this is large-scale DMLS, direct metal laser sintering, where a laser is used to fuse layers of copper powder before final laser polishing.
This is where 4D techniques first come in. We're not talking about personalised 3D printed trainers that happen to have 4D in their name here either. I mean, we're talking genuinely programmable materials.
4D printing is basically like 3D printing, except it will change at a later time when you expose it to a condition like heat or light or perhaps a liquid.
We've already developed 4D valves that will stop liquid passing the liner. And in the future, we hope to be able to control flow and contact time right through the worm thanks to adaptive pipework that expands and contracts.
One of the trickiest elements was casks. That was tough.
So we can actually build layers during the cask print process that mimic the quarter sawn stave in a traditional cask, but with way less wastage. And of course, we can print a cask whole on site.
All these innovations are great, but naturally they're not the end goal here. Once we've built up an inventory of aged stock, we'll have all the raw materials required for the final nano-level production.
4D whisky will change the way people think, not just about spirits, but about all food and drink, and perhaps the way they think about the world.
As consumers, we compromise all the time. This or this. We say screw that. Choose both. Choose everything.
So we're already creating a range of experiments in the Master of Malt lab so we can make fully programmable whiskies.
One of the most popular has been test number 764. A seemingly unpeated dram until you heat it up. We've already trademarked the name No Smoke Without Fire Whiskey.
Loads of barbecue coming through.
We've also experimented extensively with sonic stimuli. Another direction we're pushing into is chemical stimuli. So for example, concentrations of airborne allergens is something that we've been able to test.
New notes of orange. It's waxier too.
When our first release hits the shelves, we may already have reached the point where it's possible to transform a whiskey into any style imagined.
So to get from a classic fruity Speyside to an oily Mizanara and American Oak ex-fino cask finish lightly peated style, you just shine a UV light on it for 5 minutes after having lined it up with magnetic north. Then play it the blare of fire from Ocarina of Time on the wind instrument of your choice before chilling it to -7 degrees and then threatening to mix it with hard rubber soda and then not even drink it if it doesn't do what you want. Simple, really.
Sadly, we can't share our in-house experiments with you right now, but you can experience them digitally through a piece of tech we launched in 2014, our multi-sensory Joculus Snift e-drumming headset.